To maybe you can introduce yourself, like who is doing what on the company, and what is the role of both of you?
Sure. My name is Henrik, and I'm co-founder of Henchman and Goon. And on Pode, I work as a game designer mainly.
Okay.
Yeah, my name is Stefan, and I'm an artist and graphic designer here. And do some producer-like things now and then. A lot of different stuff, shader programming.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about the birth of Henchman and Goon and Pode?
Sure. Henchman and Goon started as kind of a large group of friends straight from school. And then, as we kind of worked together and tried to make a company, we kind of split up in two. And now the ones of us that are left are kind of focused on games, first and foremost. And then Pode is our second game. We actually released a game before called Phlegm. But Pode is kind of our first real game.
Okay, speaking about Pode, can you tell us a bit about the game and which supports you plan to release it on? Because we don't have so much information about it.
Sure. Pode is a puzzle exploration game,
Okay.
and it's about a small magnetic rock creature called Baldur. And he finds a fallen star,
Yeah.
and he finds a fallen star called Stella. And he wants to help her get back home.
Like the beer, you mean?
My God.
This is about finding beer.
French jokes, sorry.
French jokes. Stella
Borealis. Yeah.
But yeah, so he meets this character, and he decides to help her.
Okay.
And so the game is about getting back to the stars. And the whole game takes place inside this giant mountain. And you kind of just have to explore and overcome obstacles and use the different abilities of the different characters together and separately to overcome puzzles. And yeah.
So from what I saw, it's a cooperative game, right?
Yes, it's a single player or local co-op game.
Yeah, drop in, drop out, your friend,
Yeah.
like sitting on the couch with you, pick up a controller and join. And you can play single player and just switch between the characters.
Nice.
What were your inspirations to create this game? Like.
Well, the original idea was from our boss, who's not here.
Yeah.
Okay.
But as we've developed a game, a lot of the inspiration come from games like Journey and Lost Vikings, and the way you
Oh,
switch
Lost
between the characters and
Vikings.
stuff.
Okay.
And then we also have inspiration from movies like Wall-E,
Yeah.
Okay.
and kind of like the non-dialogue
Yeah.
relationship type story between two characters.
Okay.
Yeah. And then a lot of the visuals that we go for in this game, it's actually based off of Norwegian rose painting, like the patterns. A lot of that you can see it in the vegetation. That's something that comes up a lot, the colors that's throughout the game.
Yeah.
Okay, so why the cooperative part? Because the inspirations, I don't know.
Well, it's partly because we like games that you can play together with a friend, and
Yeah,
there's not a
or
lot of them. I mean, there's a lot of local multiplayer competitive games right now, but there's not a lot of cooperative
Yeah.
games. And so we just wanted to make one of those, and also make a game that could be played between a parent and a child.
Yeah,
Yeah.
okay.
So it's very suited for different types of couples. So it could be a girlfriend or a boyfriend, or it could be a parent and a child. And you
Smart
kind of
idea.
can decide how much one of the players are in control, because you can switch between the characters
Yeah, of
even in
course.
co-op.
Oh, okay, that's
Oh,
cool.
yeah, and
Nice.
you can decide which one of you kind of
Well,
solves the
he's going to have the
Yeah.
hard stuff and.
yeah, and which one of them are just along for the ride.
Okay.
Okay.
Speaking about the company now, how many employees are in the company right now? Because you're two here,
Yeah.
but are you just two employees?
We are five
Okay.
Yeah,
in
so
total.
it's us two and then Ingvild, our boss,
Okay.
and Lars, who works remotely, and Morten, the programmer. That's the five of us,
So
yeah.
you're four here.
The four here,
Four here.
yeah.
And then we
Okay.
also have two external partners, audio and
Okay.
music.
Okay.
Is there a specific reason why you are in Bergen in Norway, or
I
it's
mean,
because you all live here?
Well, a lot of us are from here.
Okay.
And
well, a lot.
Originally, a lot of us are from here, from the
yeah.
Okay.
When we first started the company,
yeah, the original
and then
group.
Most of us went to the same school.
Okay.
So it kind of all just started here.
Oh, you're like a group of friends.
Yeah.
And you moved to Bergen to join your boss.
Yeah, well, I'm from here.
Okay.
But yeah, some of the other people just moved to
change the cool guy.
To, to kind of study at the same school as us.
Okay.
And then it kind of just made sense to start the company here.
Okay. Is it difficult to create a game with four guy? Because this is the smallest company we visited, actually. So yeah, tell us more about it.
Well, things take time.
Yeah.
And when you're just five people, it takes even more time.
Of course.
And each one of us has to do a lot of things.
Yeah,
so even though I as a game designer, I have a huge list of things I need to do.
Mm.
But I'm also an animator, and I have to do all the animation stuff as well, and code, and so on and so forth. So kind of one of the biggest problems is that things take so much time that it takes a long time for us to see if a thing will work.
Oh, yeah.
Let's say we have,
testing.
For example, a design choice.
Okay.
We design a room to be in a specific way. And then it takes a lot of time for us to actually see if this room works, because we have to make it, we have to code it, we have to animate what has to be animated. So iteration takes even longer for us because we're so small team.
Okay.
It's hard sometimes. You can't necessarily explore, like experiment the way you want to do. So we have to go for something and try to make smart decisions. But as I said, it's, if you had more time, you could do more, but the small team, also, there's a dependency sometimes, and when you're not a lot of people and everybody does a lot of different stuff, maybe somebody has to be switched off something over to something else, because of, if that doesn't get done, then that'll be a bottleneck for something else. It's a lot of organizing, like surprising amount of organizing for such a small team.
Yeah, that's
intensive.
What I was gonna ask, isn't that hard to keep track, basically? Because if everyone is doing a lot of different stuff, you may get lost along the way, pretty much.
So. Yeah, so each of us has to kind of have their own responsibility and a kind of their own list of what they need to do. But then we also kind of give this guy some of the overall responsibility of the entire project, keeping track of whatever we need to be doing.
Yeah, the project.
Yeah. Do you use like software, like the...
Some of it, but a lot of it just gets in the way because of the, like, takes more time to actually find a solution and organize it than it would be just talking to people and writing it down. And the most important part is just talking to everybody and seeing what they need and what's going on, what's happening next.
And another thing about being a small company, we need to stay alive as a company.
Yeah.
And so in order to have a revenue stream, we have to do smaller assignments and
you're doing missions?
Yes.
To found the
contract
studio?
Contract work.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the side.
Okay,
comes,
that's interesting.
Which comes in addition to working on the game.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
what is the percent of the, I mean, mission working on the game, the repetition?
It was more before.
Yeah.
But as we kind of reorganized the company into a smaller, more games-focused company, we've been super lucky to have quite a lot of government funding.
Oh, okay.
So we've been able to focus more on the games.
Okay,
But we still do quite a lot of contract work. I don't know the...
Yeah, the actual money from the government is specified that you have to use it for the project.
Yeah,
so
yeah, of course.
Things like paying for this, all the equipment and all that stuff that...
Oh, this is not part of the...
Yeah, no, that's...
Because
not,
you
that's
pay wages, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah,
the
wages are...
Stuff?
Yeah, that's covered by the grants, but like... Paying the rent here, that needs to come from the company, not from those.
Okay.
So that's some of the stuff, the reason why we do contract work. And sometimes we're really lucky we get to do contract work that's games related.
Mm. Yeah.
But I'm a graphic designer by education, so sometimes I do stuff on the side. Like, there's a lot of different stuff. And also, Ingrid does a lot of illustration, not a lot, some on the side.
Okay.
So you live here pretty much.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Pretty
much.
24/7. How do you perceive the evolution of the video games market this last 5 to 10 years? Because has it impacted the way you make games? especially because you're a small team, and like 10 years ago you couldn't do a game with five people. Is it really different? I don't know how old are you, both of you, but yeah, what was the evolution for you for the gaming stuff and the gaming industry?
I guess we kind of started the company as the industry became more open, more indie friendly. So we've kind of never been, we haven't experienced the industry before that.
Yeah, but as player, you can, like, I don't know, maybe feel that
relate
or
a bit,
relate. I don't know.
A little bit, yeah. And I came in a couple of years later. Like, I've only been here for a year and a half now. Year and a half.
About that.
And
well, he started as an intern, so you were kind of with us from the start.
Yeah, But so I haven't seen any kind of, well, you do see stuff like the democratization of game development with Unity and that, the engines. You get a lot from that. Like, we see that we have some problems sometimes with the project. If there is something, maybe the next patch comes for Unity and it's fixed. And that's because of the way the industry has become.
Okay. One kind of advice would you give to young developers who want to start a video game industry or start a video game? Like, is that something absolutely not to do or a stuff to do? I don't know.
Well, I want to say don't do it at
all. Yeah.
That's don't do it at all?
Yeah, but that's not really advice. So,
because this is too hard. You can't succeed, you mean?
No, but that's interesting. Why would you say that?
I mean, you have to be really sure what you're getting into. Because most likely you won't make any money.
But can you be sure about, like, is it?
It's always a bet.
Sure.
But the kind of the I would say the odds are against you.
Yeah.
You have to accept that, and also Well, I guess you need to be sure that it's really what you want to do. Like, you couldn't sleep at night if you didn't pursue it.
Yeah. Okay. And you have to know that this is not just about creating video games, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. That's pay attention to other stuff would be my advice. Like, learn how to do other stuff too. Talk to people and organize and
so not code your game in your garage and try to release it yourself.
I mean, you could do that.
Yeah,
some people have and they've been successful, so nothing's impossible.
Yeah,
it's just really hard.
Okay, do you have more questions?
I think I have a last one, which is just a curiosity question, but where does the name of the group of the studio comes from?
Oh yeah, yeah. That's interesting
story,
this
that
is
a good story.
How do you pronounce?
Henchman and Goon. Right?
Henchman and Goon?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I mean, there's just a lot of reasons for it, but the main reason is kind of we wanted a name that reflected our goal to be, it's hard to explain. It kind of shows, it kind of tells you that we used to work for other bosses.
Yeah, mercenaries.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, okay.
But now we're the henchmen and we're the goons and we started our own company.
Okay.
So we're independent, basically.
Well, that's a good explanation.
Yeah.
that's a cool
idea.
Stuff.
I like it.
Okay,
I think that's
it. 15 minutes.
Thank you very much. Yeah, that's
all right.
Perfect
Thank
timing.
Thank you for your time.